Hi, my name is Judy Van Koyman, and you're watching Life Issues. My guests are Candy O'Terry and Beecher Grogan, and the topic is Life Issues, Exceptional Women, Lucy's Love Bus meets Candy O'Terry. Welcome, both of you.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome. And Candy, you've been involved in many things, and most people may know you from being on Magic 106.7, my favorite
guilty as charged, definitely.
But you have recently resigned from there. I'm sure people would like to know why.
Well, you know, I have to tell you, first of all, I love that radio station, and I always will. I feel as if it's been so much a part of my entire life. I mean, 25 years in one place is a long time. But it's really hard to get up at 3:30 in the morning. And I wanted to throw that alarm clock right out the window after 2 years of doing it. So I thought maybe it was time for me to turn the page and do some different things. So I've got a lot going on, and I can't wait to tell you about it today.
Great. Thank you. And something else that you do that's very important is that you serve as the spokesperson for American Cancer Society's Making Strides Against Breast Cancer Walk. Why is that so important to you?
Well, you know, I am what you call a motherless daughter. I lost my mom to breast cancer when I was a teenager, and it really changed the path of my life. It changed everything about my life because I think that young women need their moms, and I lost mine at a young age. And I always felt like I wasn't fully cooked. You know what I mean? I was always, I'm an only child of only children. Both my mom and dad were only children. So I had a very small, small family. And so I always felt like I was searching for role models all the time. And so when I started at Magic a few years into it, I created a program called Exceptional Women, which you had just referenced. And along the way, we interviewed 600 women, and I gotta tell you, I learned all about passion and perseverance, kindness, generosity, everything I could find out about being a good woman, I learned from the women I interviewed. So, along the way, I got an opportunity to start really connecting myself to the American Cancer Society, and particular to the fight against breast cancer. And I think when you're in radio, you know, you have a megaphone, you have a microphone, and you have more of an opportunity to tell people about your passion and see if you can connect them to it. And I don't know a single person who doesn't have someone in their life, whether it's a best friend or a coworker or a neighbor, who's been touched by this disease. Mm-hmm. And so I became very involved in the American Cancer Society, and I still am, and I intend to continue to do so. Whether I'm at Magic or not, that doesn't change my passion for the fight against breast cancer.
Of course, it's very important. And can you please tell us about Boston Women in Media and Entertainment that you co-founded?
So in my spare time, I have a wonderful friend who is just a dynamo, and her name is Dayla Arabella Santori. And she's an event architect. She's just, I mean, she's the Energizer Bunny. She's got so much energy. And I connected with her, and we created this organization a couple years ago, which is actually an offshoot of what was once the American Women in Radio and Television. And we felt when we were part of that group, as a national group, we were the New England chapter, we felt like it was not broad in scope enough. Because let's face it, media is no longer just about radio and television. It's about social media. It's about internet radio. It's about so many different things. And so we thought, why don't we create a Boston organization which could have members like you who would join us in a support network, in a mentoring environment to learn everything we can and to help each other be the most successful women we can in all aspects of media and entertainment. So we have singers, we have actresses, we have stage managers, we have agents, we have everyone involved in all aspects of media and entertainment. So we're way over 100 people, almost 200 strong now.
Wow.
And it's only been a couple years. So we're very proud of it. Right. BWME.org, there's a little plug.
All right, we'll put that up at the end of the show too. Is it just for Boston, greater Boston area?
Most of our members are all in the Boston area, or they've moved away, but they have ties to Boston. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, we're a really strong Boston networking organization for women in media and entertainment.
Mm-hmm. Great. And another thing that you do is sing, and your voice is awesome.
Oh, thank you. I'll give you your $10 at the end of the show.
Okay. And you just launched your first CD, Dream Come True. What made you want to put together the CD?
Well, first of all, I happen to have the CD, so let me show it to your camera.
Okay.
Go to CandyOTerry.com for your copy today. Okay, so Dream Come True was on my bucket list. I've been fortunate enough as a singer to have had many of my songs on the radio. And many of them were, they were on the air here in Boston, thank goodness, because Magic 106.7 played a few of them. But they also found their way all across the country and around the world. And I wanted to take all of these songs and bring them together onto one CD. And that was on my bucket list. I wanted to be able to hold my music in my hand. And I know that, you know, everybody loves downloading songs, but there's nothing like having your own CD and being able to put it in your hand and say, I did that. I finally did that. Then I had the chance to meet your next guest, Beecher, and I knew that my dream come true could be a powerful way for me to open up a new chapter in my life by doing a good deed and finding a charity I felt passionately about to give some proceeds to make a difference. So that's dream come true.
Okay, and our audience will be able to hear your awesome voice during this show. We'll have play Amazing Grace, and people will just melt when they hear it.
Oh, thank you very much. I really appreciate your support. That's wonderful. Thank you, Judy.
I tell it like it is. That's all. And now we're going to switch over to Beecher. Beecher, you're executive director of Lucy's Love Bus. Who is Lucy?
Lucy is a cutie pie over my shoulder here. Lucy was my daughter. She was 8 years old when she was diagnosed with the adult form of leukemia. It's called acute myeloid leukemia. So that was back in 2002. And you know, it was kind of a shock to our family. We were a very health-based family. I ran the farmer's market, and I just couldn't have been more shocked when that diagnosis came through. But Lucy handled it like a champ. She spent all of her days in the hospital. We spent 6 months for the first part of it was very intensive and very dangerous, so we stayed in the hospital the whole time. And Lucy just found her way of coping was to shine her light on the other children, take care of the babies. You would always find Lucy with the other kids. And I would have mothers come to my room and say, have you seen my child? Because I can't find her, and I think Lucy might have her. And so that was sort of the focus of her sickness, was how to, the way she made herself feel better was to help the other children.
And why did Lucy want to start Lucy's Love Bus?
Well, she noticed she was sick for a very long time. She was sick for a year and a half, then had some time in remission, then relapsed and was sick again. So it was 4 years total before she passed. And you know, she was 12 when she died. So when she was 11, she started looking around and saying, you know, Mama, we lost so many friends to cancer. And I see all these moms and dads raising money for cure. And she understood cure is critical. But she said, you know, for the kids, for us, what really matters is comfort and fun and quality of life. So that she saw that that was a missing piece, that no one was really focusing on that for the children. So she decided that's what she wanted to cover. When she was, she said, when I'm done with cancer, that's what we're gonna do. So.
Good.
Yeah.
Isn't that an amazing charity?
Oh, yes.
And I really think it's so unique, Beecher. I think that there's nothing quite like it.
There really isn't. We've searched because we want to partner with anyone who does anything remotely similar. And we'll find people who do nutrition or, you know, we have not found anyone else in the country out of 1.5 million nonprofits who thought the way Lucy thought, which is the immediate need of children. The immediate need is comfort and quality of life and joy. And that's what she wanted to do. So we do that by paying for integrative therapies like massage and acupuncture, Reiki, yoga, meditation, swimming, singing. We have children doing singing. We have kids doing guitar lessons. You know, and her definition of integrative therapy is anything that helps and does not hurt. So that's a pretty broad range.
And isn't joy such a powerful way to cure your soul, maybe just a little bit?
Yes.
You know? And that's where I just think she was such a special little girl. And when I met Beecher and heard the story, you know, we featured Beecher on Exceptional Women. And at that point, I was doing the show with Sue Tabb. And Sue had interviewed Beecher. And I remember coming to meet you after you and Sue had your interview and hearing the story and then really looking up the, you know, website and really going to lucyslovebus.org and learning everything and realizing this is exactly what I want to do with Dream Come True.
I think the interesting connection between us is that Candy lost her mom and I lost my girl. And I think that there's just a natural connection there. We're missing that other piece, both of us.
It's life-changing. It really is. I feel very fortunate, though, that I came down this path and met this woman and found out about Lucy.
as I call it, that horrible C word, which, mm-hmm. you know, all cancers and stuff, because I lost my husband to uh-huh. it, and I lost my youngest brother to it, mm-hmm. and other family members. So it's, you know, it can happen to anybody.
Yeah,
and,
it really
and
can.
Stuff and, yeah. and everything. So that's one reason why I'm doing this show and started the nonprofit, too, is mm-hmm. in my husband's memory. So, and that's why you continue on with Lucy's Love
Fest. Exactly.
Yeah. And with the donors' generous support, you just mentioned all the services and stuff that mm-hmm. you provide. So
that's what we do. Yeah, we've helped 315 children now.
Wow.
So we say it's $1,000 per child, but we tend to live by Lucy's rule that rules are meant to be broken and bent whenever possible. So, you know, just today, actually, we got a call from a family in Winthrop, which I thought was very ironic that that was today. It was a family fighting a disease that is not cancer, but similar to it in terms of treatment. Mm-hmm. She needs a bone marrow transplant, and the poor child couldn't breathe because it's 90 degrees and humid outside. Mm-hmm. And they called and said, the hospital called, said we need an air conditioner for this child. So it was so wonderful. Mm-hmm. Lucy was about quality of life. Air conditioning is quality of life. You need to be able to breathe.
Definitely.
So to be able to just hop on the phone, pay for it, done. Mm-hmm. You know, I know Lucy's happy when those moments happen,
mm-hmm.
and the fact that it was in Winthrop today tells me she's she's close by. Yeah,
definitely. Mm-hmm. And stuff. As Candy just mentioned, you both came together to work on this project from the Exceptional Woman when Sue Tabb mm-hmm. Interviewed you. So just those steps just came along and mm-hmm. stuff. So as I say, there's a reason for everything.
Absolutely.
And stuff. Yep. So that's very cool. And Beecher, how can people get involved in Lucy's Love Bus?
Well, there's lots of ways. We always need volunteers for events. We are always fundraising like crazy, so monthly donors, you know, is something we're always looking for. You can donate $2 a month and be a huge help to kids. So that, but we also have lots and lots of children involved with Lucy's Love Bus because a part of our mission, we do help children with cancer, obviously. The secondary part of our mission is to engage children in activism and philanthropy. We want them to live like Lucy. Mm-hmm. Lucy could not tolerate injustice. And when she heard that other children were not getting these services because they're not covered by insurance, that was the end of it. She sat up and said, this is what we're doing. So I love going to schools. We go down to third grade because I feel like, you know, the third grade children I've met can handle hearing this sad story. Yeah. We put a very positive spin on it, that this is about what Lucy did in her life. It's not about her death. And we invite the children to get involved. And I say, you know, I want you to get involved if this is something you care about. And children care about children with cancer with an incredible passion. Mm-hmm. So I invite them to get involved. I introduce them to one of our children and say, do you want to help? And those kids, we just had some kids in Webster, Mass, third, fourth, fifth, sixth grades. I met them right at the end of school. They invited me out 3 weeks later. They'd raised $4,000.
Wow. Good for them.
Selling freezer pops. Freeze pops? Those little junky pops.
Yeah.
They sold them at recess, and they raised money, and they made blankets for our children, and they wrote jokes for the children, collected stickers mm-hmm. for the children. And I love working with the kids. I mean, there's nothing more heartening for me than mm-hmm. seeing little kids get really, really, they get mad about the inequity in funding for kids. You know, there's only 3.9% of the $5 billion annual budget for cancer. 3.9% goes to kids. And when I tell 9-year-olds that, they are furious. And I say, you know, how much should go to kids? And they say, 100%. And I say, why? And they say, well, we're the future.
Of course.
And I say, you know, we say that, but they're right. They have every right to be upset mm-hmm. about this. So then I give them the address to the president of the NIH, the National Institute of Health. And I say, write to him. Write to him. And those kids are doing it. And I love seeing activism woken up in children. I think when you catch that bug early on, mm-hmm. you're an activist for life, and I mm-hmm. think the world needs more
exactly.
involved, active people.
It's amazing
always.
What little kids can
so,
do.
Yeah, so yeah. we will go to any school. If I can get there, I'll go there and speak to the kids and get them involved.
Great.
There's nothing else like this particular charity, and I'm so glad that you're having us on the show to tell everybody about mm-hmm. it, you know, all your viewers, because they should find out more about it and make
they
a donation
will.
Because this is, you know, that story that Beecher just told about getting a phone call and needing an air conditioner and being able to pick up the phone or go out and go to the box store and mm-hmm. pick up the air conditioner. I bet you delivered it that day.
It was done today.
How mm-hmm. many charities do you know
yeah.
that do that?
Yeah.
It's totally grassroots, hands-on.
Mm-hmm.
And again, there's just nothing else like that around. So
right. yeah.
Thank you, Candy. That is, we're so proud of that we get the paperwork and it is done. Right. I mean, we hook people up immediately, and families, their heads are spinning going, really? Mm-hmm. I thought this would take 6 months. We're like, we don't have 6 months. Mm-hmm. Lucy's up there
and
going,
chop,
chop.
And I think you have an mm-hmm. understanding of that urgency, yes. too. Yeah. And there are so many great charities around, mm-hmm. but some of them, because they're so big, there mm-hmm. are so many layers that you have to go
exactly.
through. And when you're a parent in a situation like that, Winthrop parent must have been today, mm-hmm. you want it done like yesterday,
yeah.
and that's what they do.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So it's pretty cool.
Yes.
So $5 from the sale of every one of these CDs goes to Lucy's Love Bus. Mm-hmm. I was able to give my first check to Beecher recently,
yeah.
and I'm so happy, and I'm just going to keep on selling CDs until I can't sell CDs anymore. So I hope your viewers will buy some, and, mm-hmm. and we can send another check Beecher's way.
Definitely, definitely. And Beecher, do you have any upcoming events?
Upcoming, we have a golf tournament coming up. We have one in Lowell coming up that's already sold out, but we have one on September 22nd out in Stowe, Mass., and that is being sponsored by Coldwell Banker Residential Brokerage Cares. Mm-hmm. They've become our new wonderful friends, and mm-hmm. they are donating all the proceeds from that event to Love Bus. So if somebody is a golfer or knows some golfers,
I wish I knew. I'm not a golfer
either. But that is our next
and
big event.
Can they get the information about that?
Yeah, everything will be on our
website
or on Facebook. It's Lucy's Love Bus on Facebook.
Okay.
And we love having people friend us there.
Of course. And Candy, can you give us your contact info?
Sure. Absolutely. So I've spent a lot of time since I'm not getting up at 3:30 in the morning. I've had some more creative time. So I have a beautiful new website called CandyOTerry.com, and the spelling is CANDY.OTERRY, CandyOTerry.com. Actually, there's no dot. Let me fix that. It's CANDYOTERRY. .com. And you can also join my Think Pink Club, join my walk team for Making Strides, and you can also right away buy your copy of Lucy's Love Bus of Dream Come True.
Okay.
Yeah.
And what is next for you?
Well, I'm really excited to tell you that I'm in the process of writing a children's book series with my daughter Colleen, mm-hmm. who's a brilliant writer. And I'd love to tell you about our story, but then I'd have to kill you because it's still sort of in a secret phase right now. Mm-hmm. But we've just written the third book. And I tell you, it's been so much fun to write the book with Colleen because when you have that mother-daughter thing going on, you have to realize that this is an equal, you know, venture here, so I can't be bossing her around. And, you know, it's kind of interesting.
Good luck with that.
But she's so good at it. She's such a
great
writer. And the series is really coming along nicely. And our hope is to find a literary agent. So if there are any literary agents out there, please go to my website and let me know who you are. But that's a big goal for us. So, but you know, I love radio far too much to be gone from it for too long. So,
okay.
And I continue doing community auditions, the TV show,
yes.
and I'm a talent judge on that, and that's lots of fun
yeah.
because we have so much local talent. So that's been a lot of fun for the past 7 seasons I've been on that
wow.
show. Yeah.
Wow. Good for you.
Busy girl.
Thank you.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. And Beecher, can we have your contact info?
You may. We have an office in Boston and an office in Amesbury. I'm going to give you the Boston number. It's 857-277-1984.
Okay.
And our website is www.luciesloveBus.org.
Great. I'm sorry, but that's all the time that we have.
What?
I know, time
we
flies.
Can't go on talking and talking and talking.
Candy, thank you for all that you do to help others.
Thank you very
and
much.
And please keep on singing.
I will.
And Beecher, thank you for helping all those children. I'm sure Lucy's very proud of you for continuing her legacy.
I hope so.
I'd love to hear your thoughts and suggestions. Please send them to lifeissuestv@gmail.com. And remember, live each day to the fullest.
Lucy's Love Bus means support. It means a chance at normalcy.
It means so much. It really, really does.
So just the thought that there was just something there for us after all we'd been through, it really felt like a miracle.
Just the name and everything that it means felt like it was, like we were blessed.
It just gave her such a bright spot when she was feeling really sad.
As a parent, Lucy's Love Bus has been tremendously helpful to me. Aside from all the wonderful things that it's done to Ella, for Ella, just to see her being able to, you know, to have the opportunity to have massage therapy, to have the chance to ride a horse, to know that there's so many other things that we can do. Having these opportunities for me as a parent, for my child, it's amazing. Words can't express how grateful I am.
Lucy's Love Bus was a beacon of hope for me. I'm actually, I've always believed in integrative therapies, and I knew I wanted that for my son, and I knew acupuncture and massage would be the best integrative therapies for him. And when I found out about Lucy's Love Bus, I thought, oh my goodness, this is just the name and everything that it means felt like it was, like we were blessed to find out about Lucy's Love Bus.
The most helpful therapy has been acupuncture, although I've also done massage and some cranial sacral work. Acupuncture has been the most helpful. It's helped me relaxing, and massage has helped to loosen up my muscles and improve my flexibility.
Well, we first heard about Lucy's Love Bus just probably about a month after Amy was diagnosed, and a social worker had come by our house to talk to us about some resources for that were available for kids that were going through cancer treatment. Well, you can pick some different therapies, and Lucy's Love Bus will help you find them and help find people that will provide them for you. And she was just so excited with the idea of picking. She was like, will it be swimming, or will it be gymnastics or art? And she was just so excited with the possibility. And it just gave her such a bright spot when she was feeling really sad.
So my son Everett had cancer this past year, and he passed away in February. And immediately I knew I wanted to keep nurturing cancer children, children with cancer. And so for me, because I had been teaching yoga for many years, I felt like that was the perfect opportunity for myself to expand and to start working with children in a way that would develop their confidence and to build their strength and to help them realize that they still have this bright light that burns within them.
I would definitely recommend Lucy's Love Bus. It's really nice to have support after everything that you've gone through. You know, you have a lot of support while you're there in the hospital getting treatment, but you know, after you're out, people, you know, forget what you've been through, but you don't forget. And so it's nice to have people who care and still acknowledge, like, you know, you went through a lot and it's okay to still need like help and need to recover more.
So just the thought that there was just something there for us after all we'd been through, I really felt like a miracle. I didn't even totally understand it. I think I read the email several times and went, really? Where did this come from?
Every year around the fall, she wrestles with anxiety. It really hits her hard. It gets a little better every year, but that's one of the areas where this has really helped, getting the massages. It's really kind of put her in a peaceful place and given her a calm that's helped her deal with a lot of those feelings.
It's so hard to put into words. Like, I feel like words don't do the experience justice. It's like, yes, I come and do stretches with him, but it's so beyond that.
In fact, after we met Tina and he started all of his yoga and that, we realized the whole family was stagnant. We had become very literal in everything we did because we were so focused on looking for a cure that we forgot to focus on ourselves. And so Love Bus and Tina sort of helped us refocus that and to realize that there's so much more to life that we need to address than just the hospitals and the medicine and sort of the cure is not just medicinal.
Do you have to stay in the hospital sometimes? Or do you just go in for the day for treatment?
I only go there every once a week for treatment, basically.
So you don't have to do long stays in the hospital?
Besides the visiting nurse, no. The only long stay we did was when, like, I got diagnosed and then we had to stay in there for, like, a month.
How have your friends handled your sickness?
They were worried about me.
Yeah, they were like,
when's Franklin's gonna come back? And then my teacher was like, a month from now, but then I didn't come back. But so they asked again, when's Franklin going to come back and stuff like that. They cried a lot. But when I came back, they were very happy to see me.
I bet they were. Were you happy to see them?
Yeah.
My daughter, Lucy Grogan, started Lucy's Love Bus when she was 11 years old. She was in the hospital coping with acute myeloid leukemia for 3.5 years when she started the charity. She looked around her and saw lots and lots of families raising money for CURE, and she knew CURE was very, very important. But she said, Mama, what about the suffering? What about the kids right here, right now, who need comfort and quality of life? And that's how Lucy's Love Bus was born.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I am found, was blind, but now I see. Through many dangers, toils, and snares, I have already come. 'Twas grace hath brought me safe thus far, and grace will lead me home. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I am found, was blind, but now I see. It's hard to keep.